Oswaldo Lopez.
Hi, Mr. Chris.
Welcome back.
Thank you very much
for the opportunity. Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome.
I don't know.
Everybody, here we have the champion of the 2011 Badwater Ultramarathon, Oswaldo Lopez. 23 hours, 21 minutes.
Yes, yes.
That's your medal. It's a small buckle. And then here's your big buckle.
Thanks.
And here's your shirt.
Oh, yeah.
It's your Moben shirt, official finisher.
All right.
So put that over your
Thank
arm.
You very much.
So, he's going to do the handshake here, though. Just put your buckle in that hand. Hold on, forward. There you go. Excellent. Everybody, looking forward. Oh, yeah. You're welcome.
Thanks.
Well done. What a star.
Yeah.
Sub 24 hours. First place. So don't go anywhere. We're gonna do a little interview and then we're gonna bring your whole crew up.
Okay.
So just stay right there.
Agua sucia, bad water.
Okay, first place, you've been out here. How many times did you crew first?
I crew in for
Jorge
2 years, 2007 and 2008.
All right.
For Jorge Pacheco, my good friend.
Yep.
A superstar.
And he won in one of those years. And then you came out and raced, and you've been second place twice.
Yes.
And first place this time, so it's been a steady progression. Well done. So what made the difference this year versus the other two? The race was very competitive, so much back and forth amongst a lot of top runners. It was really exciting. So, what made it different for you this year?
This year, exactly the words you say, many good competition.
Mm-hmm.
Michael Guardian is here. Mm-hmm. Zach Ginger is here.
Marco
Farinazzo is here. The guy from the India is here.
Yeah.
The Japanese
guys.
Yeah.
I respect for all those guys. So when I come to the race, this year I say, oh, man, this year is a good competition. I need training. Right, I need training hard.
Yeah.
Anything happen?
And so, as the race started, you held back, during the first, day, right? You didn't try to just lead from the beginning. So what was your strategy?
Same than the last year. Mm-hmm. I'm starting at a good pace because mm-hmm. I respect the heat.
Mm-hmm.
I say maybe I'm start running 9 minutes per mile or 10 minutes per mile. Mm-hmm. But I increase the pace. Everybody's, start a little faster. So when I check my watch, I'm in the 8 minutes. For miles, so I say, no, I need to slow down.
Mm-hmm.
And I slow down the pace, and maybe 9 minutes per mile during the first
day.
Maybe 40 miles.
Okay. So what place were you in, how far back did you, how many people did you let get in front of you?
Maybe, I guess maybe 12.
Wow.
When we start, maybe 12
wow.
people.
Yeah.
Or maybe a little bit more.
You're confident?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, I say, maybe, the first thing I say, maybe a little ahead I can catch up with the guys, or maybe not, but we never know.
Yeah. So when did you really start pushing the pace and really start thinking about moving towards the front?
And mile 90.
Mile around Darwin. Mile 90. So you'd already come all the way out of Death Valley, all the way out of Panamint Valley. Mm-hmm. You climbed out of there, and it kind of flattens out.
I walk a lot. I walk in for a couple hours, then the first from the stop pipe to
Town Pass.
Town Pass.
Yeah.
I for recovery, I need walk. Maybe hour and a half.
Yeah.
And I say maybe there's no time for increase the speed.
Yeah.
So when we are in the mile 90,
mm-hmm.
I'm start to running a good pace all the way to from mile 90 to Lone Pine.
Yeah, Darwin to Lone Pine. Uh-huh. So did you know how far back you were, and did you feel confident about how far back were you at Darwin from the front? How much did you have to close?
From the guys?
Yeah, no, versus the other competitors. When did you get up to the front?
Maybe when I start to see the guys.
Yeah.
And the mile, what mile is that? Mile 90, before mile 90. Yeah.
Okay.
I see a couple guys.
Yeah.
During the race. But after the mile 90, I see the other one too.
So when did you take the lead?
In the mile 100, I guess 115.
Okay.
When
and
I see that
you passed the Sakia from Japan?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Did you talk to him?
Yes, yes. I tell it, let's keep it up the pace.
Yeah.
Let's go to see you on the finish line.
Did he stay with you or did you go by?
No, just Yes, I passed.
Yeah, you passed. And then you...
I'm in a good pace. Yeah. When I see him, I see the guy is running in a good pace, but I'm running in a good pace. I keep going.
He's got long legs, that guy.
Uh-huh.
He's tall.
Yes, I'm gonna see the guy.
Yeah. So then you just took the lead, and did your crew keep track of the time split for a while between you and him?
No.
No.
No, no. We just came to doing the own race and just.
Yeah.
Just all the way to the finish line. No.
Could you ever see him behind you when you were coming up the mountain? Did you look back ever?
Yes. Yes. You know, I expect somebody's behind us.
Yeah.
So some people tell us. The guy is coming 1 mile or a couple miles or 25 minutes.
Right.
So I'm scared.
Yeah.
I'm scared about the guys. And I said, but I can run.
So did you have any problems, blisters? Did you get sick?
No. Not really. I'm sick in the mile 50 to 60.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Did you throw up? Or?
Yeah, I need the guys in the crew, they give me a good massage.
Yeah.
I'm stopped for a couple times for 5 or 10 minutes.
Wow.
And I come back again.
All right.
Okay. And what were you eating and drinking?
Gatorade, mm-hmm. water, Gatorade, mm-hmm. all the time.
Yeah.
And Coca.
Wow.
Sodas.
Old school
sodas.
Style. Yeah.
School.
Did you eat any food?
Any food? No, just watermelon and corn nuts.
Watermelon, wow. And corn nuts.
Watermelon and corn nuts.
Yeah.
No more.
Yeah. Okay. Well, anything else you want to add, or bring your crew up?
No, I we're gonna say thank you very much for all support during the race, from all people. Thanks to the moving company, to my people support from the Mexicano Park. A lot of good person helped me to come to this race.
Yeah.
And my friends, especially to the good crew we have, and the last year the other guys crewing me, Pánfilo Jiménez, Rudy Montoya. Angel Perez, the other guys coming the last year to help me. Yes, when I say thank you, and thank you guys for the opportunity.
You're
for
welcome.
For running. Yeah.
Now, just introduce yourself in Spanish and say, hey, I'm standing here at Whitney Portal, and I just won this race, and just, you know, for a minute or two.
En Spanish?
In Spanish, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, mi nombre es Oswaldo Nava López. Vengo de México y estoy muy, muy orgulloso y representé muy bien a México porque esta carrera se la dedico a mi país, que es México, y a toda nuestra gente latina, toda la gente de Latinoamérica. Yo le dedico esta carrera a toda la gente de Latinoamérica. ¡Y que viva México! ¡Viva México!
And the race, say how long the race is and the route and where it went.
Esta carrera se le nombra la carrera más difícil del mundo, puesto que es una travesía muy... muy larga, muy dura, las temperaturas de 135 millas y con una temperatura muy, pues muy caliente y el curso pues un poco difícil, pero muy bonita la carrera.
And where did you start and where did you finish?
We start in Badwater.
Finish.
On the finish line, right here.
En español.
Yes. Empezamos allá en Badwater, en el Valle de la Muerte y terminamos aquí, cerquita de Mount Whitney, aquí en los portales, aquí junto a los pinos y las rocas.
Big pines.
Sí, junto a los pinos grandes.
All right, well, congratulations.
Yeah.